happens to be, it's a Tuesday, huh? Now, yesterday, for all of you that did manage to see a very, very sad video, it was out there, but anywho, my name is Tina Fierce One. Welcome to Scoop and Scoop. So, if you did get the chance yesterday, I know you saw that video of Pretty Glow. It was a very, very sad video to watch, to be honest. It was very sad to watch and funny in some ways. And yes, I say funny because I'm a realist, you know. I love to look at things practically, bust out laugh at them, then finally condense and take them in and then think of a situation and a solution. Anyway, for those of you who saw it, that went down. Yes, she was apparently caught in a supermarket trying to steal something to eat. Now, we had all forgotten this chick. The only reason we remembered Pretty Glow is simply because when the whole cute Kaye thing in Obutala happened, she popped out and she had just given birth then. So they were living together, there was a situation. I asked about cute Kaye. I'm like, yeah, cute Kaye, it seems he was taken to rehab. But the question here remains, why would they take only cute Kaye and leave her because they were living together? And why is everybody insisting on drugs? How sure are you that this girl was on drugs? How about it would just be plain brokenness, plain starvation, plain any of those things? How come everybody's like drugs, 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 drugs? And what pissed me off the most is how everyone came up with their own conclusions. You know, I came up with mine too. I did. After feeling sympathetic, I decided to go back into beast mode. This is a call out. Now I know mwalabia ka video ka Bad Black. First of all, ngasine yongera kubizibu bya Pretty Glow. Bad Black ya gambye amanye number ye amanye jali amumutu seka yagala mujanjoba yagala musasulira rent yagala mukolera buli chimu. Then I was like, Captain Severho is coming to our rescue. But no, Bad Black, I have said this before, you're already answering very many cases. Please, tukoye, if you want to Snapchat, Snapchat for your friends, Snapchat for your close friends and family, Snapchat and keep that ish archive. Nkoye kumpe mula at every turn I get. Nkoye. Like, yes, we know you're a whore. We know kalori malaya, tuchimanyi mamo, che, oche nyumirizamu nyo. Well, mu advice, wala bia bizibu bia Pretty Glow wa mugambia, che mwagende yetunde. Nawe, tukumanyi ndo woza iyo wetyo. Tetuza wana kusubira mundo woza ya wini bia nyima. Ila tugenda kulo woleza mundo woza yeyachi, eyobu malaya. Na ye, mama ne misege jibe ilako ne mpisa. Totu kakukubo na wasanga angabale ere sagagambo gabaga nene wegati. Bad Black. I am sick and tired. And honestly speaking, for me, it's about to get physical. It's about to get physical. It's about to get into a Twitter situation. I'm going to start tweeting at Father Lokodo to have you taken off in the internet. I'm tired. We can't be waking up every morning. We're trying to deal with life and all its hassles. And Bad Black is there being a motivational speaker. Kubachi mani mwagala nye bintu byayogera. Naba we mula. Naba we mula. Naba tu seri. Pampanja gala kukumpe mula. Ngenda neno nye bina tumie. I mean, if I didn't send for you to tell me certain words, why should you? And then you put them on social and then abasegu banebe babi sharing. I'm like, please. Anyway, I'm done with the Bad Black rant. Let's go back to Pretty Glow. So, after Bad Black said that, Robin Kisitu, or Kirsty, should I say, took a minute to also go on Facebook Live, and you know, she was just trying to be inspirational. Different people came out trying to say the same thing, and this is what we're going to say. But you said Pretty Gloria Kazal, umwana yenkanawa. Ya weza zanemia zinga munana. Now, she could be suffering all that weight loss from just poverty, pregnancy, postnatal, she's not being looked after well. Kupoli weba kusangida ngo genze kubecho ukulia. Eba anjala, I don't have face over domu laba anjala. But kanebuze, two dimwits. Yes, I'm not feeling sorry right now because you know, muba kuata meme, neba turning out like this. Muba kuata meme, and then we have to deal with this nonsense of feeling sorry on your behalf. Two grown-up adults consented to living with each other, had a baby, and could not for the life of me think about getting out to get a freaking day job. who the hell are these idiots? Like, I know crackheads are on some ish, but who are these crackheads? Like, cute kaya bamkwata babutala. Ona mamkutaba chakulia. Abantu babidi, everybody could not stand up and say, Mama Gundi, gendo yozengo ye kumulidwana, nkumi satu tuja kufune chokulia. Tata Gundi, gendo pamba neopota ringe walebi ya cute kaya bijeo wanu. What happened? What happened to... Let me tell you, nothing hurts like being a former rich man. A former rich man. You would rather be a former broke person. But a former rich man. You're still living in that mentality of, I was once a celebrity. Ooh, I was once known. You're going to starve and look like pretty glow. Me, hands off. I'm not going to feel sorry for her. I'm not. Kambabuli rolaba jine mikono, me as Tina. If anything went down, I have 3 babies, you would find me cleaning the roads with KCCA because I have to secure the bank for my kids. You would find me doing your laundry and I'm like, ebi aliwo, woman's gotta eat. So someone explain to me why Pretty Glow as a woman could not motivate cute Kaya to get a decent job or could not tell herself, we need a job. I know everyone is going to be like, Naetina, nawe, embera, uyo gerabu, bichiri kutukako, chiri kutukako. Y'all don't even know half of the lives that we have lived. You don't. Mutulabidawa, no. You do not know half of the lives that we have lived. But we have lived these lives because we choose to live life. We choose not to give up on life. That was her giving up. Honestly speaking, there's no two ways about it. Cute Kaya and Pretty Glow had given up on life. They felt like life, they're not going to do anything. And this goes without saying. I know everyone was saying, well, you just want to be slay queens and all of that. No, Pretty Glow was not really a slay queen. It was just a moment, you know? She was part of the high time life. That doesn't make her a slay queen. This goes without saying. Ladies, mess around and keep thinking that the world is your oyster. If you have not actually decided to make it your oyster, mess around. Mess around and think everything is going to come at you because you're a girl, because the world will feel sympathetic, or because you have babies. Let me tell you, it's a messed up world out here. And closed mouths. Don't get fed on this boulevard. That's just it. Get up, go get a job, look after you. If you have a man that is going to help look after you and his wife, too good for you. Support that man to keep securing the bag. We are tired of this nyokari. I don't know who is in perfect. Anyway, baby, we are pretty good. We don't know for sure. I want to find out today what her way forward is. I don't see much coming though. I don't see much happening. But hey, yeah. Oh yeah. Before I can say bye, I was talking about some very annoying women. Let me talk about women who know how to secure the bag. Let me talk about women who know how to get their hands dirty so that they can secure the bag. Let me talk about the type of women that I want my kids to turn into. Big shout out to none other than Grace Mgoji, who was, she tells us she has curvy guts. Do you think Chiwanda would be interested in those ones? There could be a tourist attraction. Grace Mgoji, I salute you. I'm always humbled when I have to talk about you. That aside, at Tina VS1 is my Twitter handle. On Facebook, we are Scoop and Scoop. And at Tina VS1, not forgetting on Instagram, at Tina VS1 with an H. I'll catch you, yeah, tomorrow. I'm out. Peace.